This testis is a male gonad which is hanging via the spermatic cord. It is covered by the tunica albuginea, which is a thickened covering of collagen fibers. Next to that, it is covered by the visceral peritoneum. This visceral peritoneum is tucked in between the lateral side of testis and the epididymis, and this space is known as the sinus of the epididymis. Epididymis consists of a head, body and tail, and from the tail the ductus deferens starts, which passes on the medial side of the epididymis and continues into the spermatic cord. From there it passes into the superficial inguinal ring, inguinal canal and the deep inguinal ring. At the level of deep inguinal ring, it curves medially, crosses the pelvic brim and goes at the base of the urinary bladder. In the male genital organs, we have the testis, epididymis and the ductus deferens. Besides, the main copulatory organ is the penis. The penis has been cut in a transverse section. It shows the dorsal part of the penis, which is made up of two bodies which are known as the corpora cavernosa, and the ventral body which has finer tissue which is known as the corpus spongiosum. This corpus spongiosum is traversed by the urethra, and at the tip of the penis there is the glans penis. Pelvis is a basin shaped structure bounded by pubic symphysis anteriorly, sacrum and coccyx posteriorly. The contents of the pelvis anteriorly in relation to the pubic symphysis, back of pubic symphysis, is the urinary bladder into which the two ureters open. At the neck of the bladder is a solid fibromuscular glandular organ, which is the prostate gland. Still posterior to the prostate is the lower part of the rectum, and continuous downwards and backwards as the anal canal. There are sphincter, the internal sphincter of the anal canal and the external sphincter of the anal canal. The external sphincter consists of deep fibers, superficial fibers and the subcutaneous fibers. Besides that, in the pelvis we see the common iliac artery. This is the common iliac artery, which divides into external iliac and an internal iliac. The internal iliac artery crosses the brim of the pelvis and divides into number of visceral and parietal branches. The external iliac artery continues at the mid inguinal point with the femoral artery. Medial to the external iliac artery is the external iliac vein, which joins with the internal iliac vein to form the common iliac vein. These are the structures in the male pelvis.